take some extra effort to get there, and then the approach is harder than you would do for most sport climbing crags. It takes extra effort, but it makes the reward that much more special. And thank God it exists, because I don't know what I would have done for the last decade without it. It certainly occupied some time. So this route is a combination of two routes that I had done previously, and it became a much cooler connection to actually add a whole new section of really good hard climbing down in the best rock. And then the upper crux is pretty low percentage. It's one super hard move at the top of the crag. And so I realized that like the only way to make the top acceptably high percentage was really just to get stronger. I spent a ton of time bouldering this winter. Coming back this spring, like it felt the way I wanted it to feel, and that upper move was so much better, but then it definitely took some time to gain the fitness for the bottom. I think that is challenging on the route, to have the power endurance for the bottom and then just like the bouldering power for the top.
Come on.
route is amazing. It's fantastic. Just compared to other things I've done in Lander and other 9As I've done, it just seems harder. I do believe it's the hardest thing I've ever done. I could be super conservative and call it another 9A and it would never get repeated and we'd never know. I would love for there to be a 9A plus here, and if there were going to be one, I think it would be this one, so what the hell.